We now have governing equations in terms of the scalar vorticity and the stream function. We don't really know what the meaning of the stream function is yet, but it turns out to be an excellent field for visualizing steady flows. So this is the definition of the stream function in terms of the velocity field. Now, if we draw what's called a streamline of the velocity field, so the fluid then is flowing in the direction of the streamline, then this is the velocity field, U. This is a steady flow, so this is independent of time. Now, if we draw a vector along this streamline, let me draw an infinitesimal vector. So this will be our infinitesimal vector, which I'll call dr. So dr then is along u. Now let's remember our polar coordinates. So our radial vector is equal to r times r hat. So what is this infinitesimal vector? So dr is equal to, we need to use the product rule here because r hat depends on theta. So this is dr times r hat plus r times dr hat. So dr hat now is dr hat d theta times d theta. But dr hat d theta is theta hat. So this is equal to dr r hat plus r d theta theta hat. Okay? Dr now is in the same direction as u. So we can make use of that. We know then that the cross product of u and dr will be zero. So we have a zero is equal to u cross dr. And what is this in polar coordinates? So u is ur r hat plus u theta theta hat. And dr is what we just derived. So dr r hat plus r d theta theta hat. We can do this cross product because r hat cross r hat is zero. R hat cross theta hat is k, the unit vector in the z direction, and theta hat cross theta hat is zero. So we need just the cross terms here. So we'll start with theta hat cross r hat, which is minus k. So that will give us a negative sign, so minus u theta dr. And then r hat cross theta hat is plus k, so that would be plus r u r d theta. And this is all in the k direction, the z axis direction. This is supposed to be zero, but what is this inside? If we go back to our definition of the stream function, u theta is just negative d psi dr, partial of the stream function with respect to r. The minus signs cancel, so that becomes partial of psi with respect to r dr. And r u r is partial of psi with respect to theta, so that becomes partial of psi with respect to theta d theta. And that's a vector in the k direction. Okay, what is this? Well, this is just the definition of d psi in the k direction. So this is our infinitesimal d psi. So because u cross dr is equal to zero, we get d psi then is equal to zero. Okay? So on the streamline, psi doesn't change. D psi is equal to zero. So therefore, psi is constant on streamlines. Okay? The streamlines are just the curves that follow the fluid as it flows, so following the velocity. And in a steady flow, those curves don't change. Those curves are fixed. So this gives us an excellent tool for a visualization in a steady flow. What we need to visualize the velocity field, all we need to do is plot the contours of the stream function. So this is our main visualization tool, is the contour lines of the stream function psi. MATLAB gives us built-in functions that can plot contour lines of a scalar field. So let me summarize. We've introduced a stream function in order to eliminate the two components of the velocity field. It turns out the stream function has a very clear meaning. If we plot a streamline, which is a curve which follows the flow of a fluid, so the velocity is along the streamline, then the stream function is constant along the streamline. So by plotting curves of constant stream function, we can plot the streamlines and have a clear visualization of the flow field. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.